Hello, myself Mrunal. Today I am going to explain about the physiography of India by the help of the PPT. What do you know about the term physiography? Physiography simply means physical geography. Here you can see the physical map of India. Physiographic division of India are the Himalayas, the North Indian Plains, the Peninsula, the Coastal Plain, and the island groups. The Himalaya is one of the youngest mountains in the world. The Himalayas extend from Pamir North in the Tajikistan to the east. It is a major mountain system of the Asian continent. In India, it extends from Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh. There are long and high mountain ranges in northern and northeastern part of India, in the form of Himalayan ranges. The average altitude of the greater Himalaya is around 6,000 meter. The next is the North Indian Plain. This division lies between Himalayan mountain in the north and the peninsula in the south. Similarly, it extends from Rajasthan and Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. It is mostly a flat lying area. The western part of the North Indian Plains is occupied by the Thar Desert or Marustali. Most of the Rajasthan is occupied by the desert. You can see the image of the North Indian Plains. The next is the peninsula. The peninsula. The area lying to the south of North Indian Plains and tapering towards the Indian Ocean is called Indian Peninsula. It consists of many plateaus and hill ranges. The western ghats and the eastern ghats lies to the west and east of the peninsula region. Here you can see the image of the peninsula. The next is the coastal plain of India. India has a coastline of approximately 7,500 kilometers. It lies to the western and eastern part of India. You can see the west coast plain here and the east coast plain. Many east flowing rivers rising from the western and eastern ghats meet the eastern coast. The next is the island group. India has many small and large islands along the coast of the mainland. These are included in the coastal island group. The island in the Bay of Bengal are called the Andaman and Nicobar Island. Here you can see the image of the Andaman and Nicobar Island. The island in the Arabian Sea are known as Lakshadweep Island. Here, similarly, you can see the image of Lakshadweep Island. The island in India are either volcanic or coral origin. Thank you.
Okay, start.
Good morning, teacher, and my dear friends. Today we are here to learn about one main aspect of geography, that is wildlife in Brazil. So Brazil is an equatorial country and it is located in the South American continent. Basically, equator passes through Brazil, therefore wide varieties of plant and animal species are present. So let us learn about it in detail. Brazil holds the largest tract of unspoiled rainforest on earth and it accounts for 60% of the Amazon rainforest. Brazil is a country where a major river basin called as Amazon basin is present and there are huge varieties of species are found. So Brazil is considered as the greatest diversity of animals and plants as compared to any other country. It includes hummingbirds, toucans, parrots, condors, macaws, waterfowls and birds of prey. Also, it also includes mammals like capybaras, sloths, monkeys, anteaters, pumas, jaguars, armadillos, otters, and dolphins, etc. are also found in Brazil. That is because the vast latitudinal extent of Brazil, as well as the wide variety of Amazon availability of water. This is one major species, water species, which is found in Brazil, that is blue shark. It is the highest species which we speak about when compared, and it is most dangerous as well. Blue sharks are common in both salt water as well as in fresh water. That is, they will be found in ocean as well as in river water sources. They are the most dangerous animal of the entire species. They are most frequent species to attack humans, and they are like to live in populated areas. But other than humans, bull sharks feed on other sharks and as well as bony fish. This is the most attractive species of Brazil, that is called as pin dolphins, and it adds beauty to the vegetation species and as well as to Brazil's wildlife species. That is, the Amazon River dolphin is also known as Boto or pink river dolphin. It is the largest species of river dolphin. It feeds upon 53 different species of fish such as crocos, catfish, tetras, pyrenees. It also consumes river turtles and freshwater crabs. The texture of the body is strong and healthy, but they are flexible. Their body is very strong, but they can move their body in any way they want to. That is, they are flexible. The body color varies with ages. It is not pink throughout the age, but it changes in changing age. The difference in color. Now, what does the difference in color depends upon? It depends upon the temperature, water transparency, and geographical location, the place where they are located, and the natural resources, minerals available to them. This is another major species of Brazil, that is Brazilian wandering spider. The Brazilian wandering spider is also known as the banana spider since its shape is as well structured. It is one of the most aggressive and venomous spider known to human. There are 8 species, all of which it can be found in the Amazon rainforest. Their venom is extremely poisonous. If it bites someone, they can suffer from intense pain, or if not treated, they can suffer from paralysis, and that is very common. Now, whenever we speak about wildlife, there are varieties of animals and plants present in a country. But the main important thing is we should preserve and conserve with all our needs. That is, but the humans play a very vital role in destroying this wildlife because of their activities like pollution, poaching, hunting, burning and slash agriculture. So that is a thing we should not do and avoid it, so as to preserve such beautiful species of animals and birds. So first endangered species of wildlife of Brazil is Tocateca. Basically, whenever we speak, its beak is very huge, and this beak adds beauty to this animal. The Tocateca is the largest and best known of the 7 Tocateca species found in the Amazon. Their plumage is mainly black on the body and white on the face, and short with a yellow and blue green of skin around the eyes. So it is basically very huge animal. The most striking feature is their oversized bill, which is orange yellow in color and measures between 6 and 9 inches. That is its beak. Next is squirrel monkey. This is called a squirrel monkey. That is because it is very small and it cannot climb trees like other monkeys. So that is the reason it is called a squirrel monkey. And also it looks attractive to the tourists visiting Brazil. Often seen throughout the Amazon basin, these monkeys are called squirrel because they are really small and agile and spend most of their life in trees, feeding primarily on fruits and insects. Unlike most of the monkeys, they can't use their tail for climbing. On average, these monkeys range between 9.8 and 14 inches in height and they weigh for 1.7 to 2.4 pounds. They have short brown gray fur on their head and shoulders and yellow upper fur on their back and extremities. The fur on their face is black and white. So thank you, this was about it. But basically, whenever we speak about any country's wildlife, the main important thing is to conserve and preserve, and that lies with us. We have to take care of it because none other person can do it, because humans are considered very important part or aspect of vital factors. So thank you.
Okay, Kushi, very good. Keep it up. Start.
Good morning, one and all. My respected teachers and my dear friends. Myself, Preeti Nag from Standard 10C, and today I'm going to present the topic of geography, urbanization in India. So, what is urbanization? The word includes urban. That urbanization is related to cities. Urbanization is nothing but the process of making an area urban. It refers to the population change to urban areas, that is, from villages to cities, the decrease in proportion of people in rural areas, and the way in which societies adapt to these changes. But what is the need of urbanization? Is it real for the society? The answer is yes. Urbanization is an inevitable part of human progress, of the urbanization. The growth of urbanization. Good morning, one and all. My respected teachers and my dear friends. Myself, Preeti Nag from Standard 10C, and today I'm going to present the topic of geography, urbanization in India. So, to begin with, what is urbanization? As the word itself includes urban, urbanization is related to cities. Urbanization is nothing but the process of making an area more urban. It refers to the population shift from rural to urban areas, that is, from villages to cities. The decrease in the proportion of people areas, the way in which societies adapt to this change. But what is the need of urbanization? Is it really for the society? The answer is yes. Urbanization is an inevitable part of human progress and also the goal of modernization. The growth of urbanization results in the development of the world economy and contributes to the emerging level of industrialization. Now, as the concept of urbanization and its need for the society is clear, let us move towards the main topic of the day, that is urbanization in India. India was under the dominance of British for more than 1.5 centuries. Urbanizing in India began to accelerate after independence due to the country's adoption of a mixed economy, which gave rise to the development of the private sector. Population and economic growth has fostered urbanization in the country, and the number of urban towns and cities have increased drastically. This growth is expected to continue years to come. Talking of the urbanization in India, the urban population has been increasing consistently from 1961 to 2011. From 1961 to 1981, this growth was around 5.5% only. But from 1980 to 2011, growth was 3%. There are various factors responsible for the urbanization in India. Concentration of increase and development of particular region are indications of urbanization. Industrialization, that is, concentration of industries have historically led to urbanizing by creating economic growth opportunities that brought people to cities. For example, in the 19th century, Mumbai grew because textile on a large scale in Mumbai. Today, a number of major industries like steel, jute, sugar, cement, IT have developed in many parts. Trade services develop in areas which provide favorable transport. Business complex, shopping malls, trucks start growing, making the place an urban area. For example, Nagpur is centrally located in India, and urbanization started in other factors like migration, transport, and communication, extra. Urbanization. As more and more places, it develops and becomes more urban. Migration occurs usually from rural to urban areas and urban to urban areas in the extraction of higher standard of living. For example, it occurs in cities like Mumbai, Pune. Urban occurs in places facilitating proper transport like roadways, railways, airways, extra. For example, after the development of Kong Railway, many villages like Savarde, District Ratnagiri, lying close to its proximity, have started urbanizing. Urbanization also has its merits and demerits. In India, it had faced challenges and some good effects as well.
Industrialization, trade, transport and communication have developed to a great extent in India. People living in urban areas get advantage of updated knowledge and literature. Various amenities and facilities like transportation, communication, educational and medicational facilities developed in an urbanized region. For example, students and patients visit metropolitan cities like Mumbai, Kolkata, Delhi for educational and medicational purposes. Social modernization and facilities are some other highlights of urban. But as a coin has its two faces, in the same way, various problems have erupted due to excessive population in urban areas and accumulation of slums have increased due to urbanization. People attracted to the high living rush to the cities cause new population, which result in an unhygienic condition. For example, the slums in Dharavi, Mumbai. Traffic jams and pollution have been the major problems in cities. Public transport not being sufficient for people has given rise to private transport. Trams are very common in the roads of Mumbai. Due to increased private transport, level of pollution has increased due to urbanization. Delhi can be the best example in this aspect. Most dangerous effects increased thefts, burglaries, murders have increased because people rushing to cities do not always get employment opportunities. Thus, look for means of earning illegal ways, and the crime rates increase drastically. Urbanization is extremely necessary, but we should eradicate the challenge posed by it. A country, good man, is less compared in comparison to other developed nations. It's more urbanized than the part. Goa, being the most urbanized state, has 62% of its population living in urban areas, whereas Delhi is more than 80% urban. We must try harder all states of equally and become a global leader. For this, we must make necessary efforts in education and diversification. Thank you.
Okay. You did very well. But somewhere it is, the voice is getting big. Okay. Your concept is good. Your explanation is also good. But somewhere because of network issue, the voice is getting big.
My name is, 1 second, ma'am.
Yes, start.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Bhumi from Standard 10th A. So today is my topic is India's population. So you can see in this map there is a population, more population in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. So why there is more population here? Why not somewhere else? Because of more availability of basic facilities, more availability of water and etc. So India's population is India is the second most populated country in the world, and it ranks 5th for the world population. So according to the 2019 world population prospect population, means it has in 2019 our India's country's population was 1,35,26,42,280. That is 136.6 crore. In that population, there were 71.7 crore males and 66.3 crore female living in India. So during 1975 to 2010, our population doubled to 1.2 billion, and the Indian population reached the billion mark in 1998. So the population in India there is 50% of population below the ages of 25, means below the ages of 25, there is a population of 50%. And below the ages of 35, there is a population of 65%. Then, world population. According to Census 2011, our population was 8,54,977, and our country having 17.5% of its world population, and our density of population was 382 per square kilometer. Now, this is the map related to the 2019 population pyramid graph. So, in this you can see we have the 0 to 4 population. It is male were 4.5 and female were 4.1. 5 to 9, 4.6 and 4.2. 10 to 14, 4.9 and 4.2 and so on. But you can see here there is no population to 90 to 100 ages. It's 0.0. And in 85 to 89, there is only 0.1 population. So now I'm going to talk about literacy rate. Our literacy rate is around 74.03% as per 2011, and life expectancy is 69.16 years according to the 2011, and growth rate is 1.3 according to 2011. And from 2011 to 2019 in India, there were 909 females as per the 1,000 males. This is the map graph related to population growth rate as per 2011 census. You can see in 2011 there is 1.3 annual change as per 2011 census. Thank you.
Okay, Bhumi, very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. Stop your screen.
Natural vegetation allows individual species to adjust themselves to climate and soil conditions as fully as possible. In India, India is a land of great natural vegetation. There are many types of vegetation. Depending upon the variation in the climate and the soil, the vegetation of India changes from one region to another. Let's talk about the first one, the tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forests have an average rainfall of 200 cm and have an average temperature of 24 degrees Celsius. It is found at hot and humid areas of India like Western Ghats, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and Eastern India. Tropical evergreen forests. Tropical evergreen forests are tall and dense with their height ranging from 45 to 60 meters. The trees compete and rise high to get sunlight. Example, rubber trees, coconut trees, ebony trees, and mahogany palms, etc. The second one is tropical deciduous forest. Tropical deciduous forests have an average rainfall of 100 to 200 centimeters and their average height is 25 to 45 meters. They shed their leaves in summer due to shortage of water. It is found at Shivalik, Ganga Valley, Western Ghats, and Northeastern India. They are economically very important forests because we get majority of raw wood from this forest. For example, sal, teak, sisam, sandalwood, deodar, mahua, etc. The third one is tropical dry forest. Tropical dry forests have an average rainfall of 50 to 100 centimeters and they are less dense in size, is 6 to 9 meters. Their roots are thick and long to use underground water, and the thick bark prevents undue evaporation. Tropical dry forest. They are found in Punjab, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, Eastern Rajasthan, Central Deccan Plateau. Most of the areas are used for agriculture. Dwarf deciduous trees and long grasses grow in this region. Example, neem, sheesham, babul, peepal, mango, etc. The fourth one is arid or desert forest. Desert forest has an average rainfall of less than 50 centimeters. Prominent features of desert forest are small leaves, thick bark, and long roots. Indian wild date is common in this desert. Arid or desert forest. It is found at western Rajasthan, southwest Haryana, Punjab, and in some part of Gujarat. Example, small-sized cedar, babul, acacia, bushes, and shrubs. The fifth one is tidal forest. Tidal or mangrove forest. This forest grow along the coast and the edges of the delta. Famous for mangrove and this Sundari trees consists of thick bushes and ferns. Tidal or mangrove forest. They are known as halophytes, that is tolerant or salinity. Found at Sundarbans, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. The sixth one is forest cover in India. Indian Forest Service reports. The forest area covers 21.34% of the total land area of the country. Actual forest cover is the area occupied by the forest with canopy. Forest cover is based on aerial photographers and the satellite imagery. The forest policy aimed at bringing 33% of the geographical areas under forest cover, maintaining environmental stability, and to restore forests where ecologically balance was disturbed. The forest policy aimed at increasing the forest cover through social forestry and afforestation of degraded land, increasing the productivity of forests to make timber, fuel, fodder, and food available to rural population and dependent on forests. The forest policy aimed at creating a massive people's movement involving women to encourage planting of trees, stop felling of trees, and thus reduce pressure on the existing forest. Rural forestry lays emphasis on promotion of agroforestry and community forestry. The process under which farmers grow trees for commercial and non-commercial purpose. Intricate and interrelationship with life and environment. There is an direct and indirect advantages of the economy and our society. Therefore, it is necessary to for the conservation of plants for the mankind of people and for its prosperity. The government of India proposed to have a nationwide forest conservation policy and adopted a forest policy in 1952, which have further modified in 1988. Government will emphasize sustainable forest management. Thank you.